Good afternoon, everyone. Please continue to eat while we start the program, but we want to get going. We know it's been a busy morning, and people probably have other places they need to go this afternoon. It's such a nice warm day. You can head out to the park. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Michelle Goode, and I'm the City of Fort Worth's Communications and Public Engagement Director. I hope you enjoyed the morning's workshops and visiting with our exhibitors. And I'd like to welcome you to the 14th Annual Fort Worth Neighborhood Awards. We'd like to begin today with an invocation by Pastor Tim Woody from City Life Center. Pastor Woody?
First of all, I just want to say God bless all of you for serving to make our city an amazing place to live, do business, worship, and play. I love my city. This guy loves Fort Worth, and I know you do too. Let's pray, please. Dear God, I come to you today to pray blessing over my city, over Mayor Betsy Price, our city council, and all of our city leaders. I also pray for Michelle Goode and Catherine Huckabee and the staff and all the amazing volunteer leaders who are here today. Pray blessing over this gathering of some of the most committed and passionate citizens in my city. God, continue to surround us with encouragers and peacemakers and can-do people. God, also may unity prevail as we continue working together to build a stronger community, for no city divided against itself will last or continue to stand. So God, let Fort Worth be marked by harmony, compassion, and peace and vision. Bless our leaders, public servants, and our volunteers. Bless our houses of worship. Bless our neighborhoods. God bless our families, and God bless our homes, and God bless my city, Fort Worth. En el nombre de Jesús, amén. Dios te bendiga, mi amigos.
Thank you, Pastor. We also have many special guests with us today. First, I'd like to recognize our elected officials. Could you please stand and remain standing as I say your name? State Representative Nicole Collier. Is she here today? Lee Collins from State Senator Connie Burton's office. Tarrant County Judge Glenn Whitley. Of course, Mayor Betsy Price. City Council members Gina Bivens, Sal Espino, Kelly Allen Gray, Junkus Jordan, Carrie Moon, Dennis Shingleton, Ann Zeta, and Zim Zimmerman. Let's give them a round of applause. I would also like to recognize former city council member Danny Scarth, who's joining us today. Danny's sitting over here. And County Clerk Mary Louise Garcia. Sorry. We also have many city staff members here today, so if you are a staff member for the City of Fort Worth, would you please stand so we can recognize you? Next, I'd like to recognize the community engagement team for organizing today's workshops, exhibitors, and award luncheon. In addition to this annual event, most of you know they work very closely year-round with your neighborhoods and other community groups and city staff. Their mission is to connect you with city services, resources, and each other to help build a strong community. If you don't know these folks yet, please introduce yourself while you're here and find out how they can begin helping your neighborhood. Would the community engagement team please stand? They may be working. The first award that will be given today is given by the League of Neighborhoods. To present this award, I'd like to introduce Eva Bonilla, winner of the 2014 Ben Ann Tomeko Award and past president of the League of Neighborhoods. Eva.
Thank you. Thank you. First of all, I just want to read how they won and why they won. For the 2016 Ben Antemake Award, it recognizes an individual who demonstrates a high level of support, an individual neighborhood, or a group of neighborhoods or neighbors throughout Fort Worth. And I say that because a lot of you see each other in different capacities because you're working out in the neighborhoods. But anyway, we have two finalists, so I'm going to call them out first and tell you why they won. And I'm going to have Rita Vinson, who's just a media past chair of the Fort Worth League of Neighborhood, take them their certificate. So when I call your name, if you'll please stand. The Fort Worth League of Neighborhood recognizes Linda Dennison from the Heritage Homeowners Association as a finalist. Oh, there she is, Linda, that's awesome. And the next one who was a finalist was Fred and Phyllis Anglin from the Oakhurst Neighborhood Association. These are outstanding people, and it was really tough for the committee to choose on a winner. And if you know them personally, you know that they probably deserved, but we can only pick one winner. And that winner is Alice Boyd. And she is not here. The person that from Ryan Wood that will be, is there somebody from Ryan Wood who is here who can accept it? I want them to come up. Alice Boyd, we're giving this award posthumous because she passed away just this year. But Alice has worked in neighborhoods since the 80s. And I served on the League of Neighborhood Board with her in the early 2000s. And she, for two decades, she led her neighborhood. And as charter president of Ryan Wood Neighborhood Association, as co-sponsor of Neighborhoods of the East Fort Worth Alliance, and as secretary of the Fort Worth League of Neighborhood, the committee chose Alice Boyd. Thank you. And with that, she gets $100 that is given to Ryan Wood. Thank you.
Thank you. The City of Fort Worth created the Neighborhood Awards well over a decade ago to recognize a variety of projects and activities that help make Fort Worth a great place to live, work, and play. This year, based on your feedback, we hand out two awards in each category. As most of you know, mandatory homeowners associations sometimes have full-time paid staff. Voluntary neighborhood associations do not. So beginning this year, these two groups are competing against their peers and not each other. So in each of the categories, you'll notice there is an HOA winner, and then there's also a neighborhood association winner. We'd also like to give out three individual awards today and are proud to partner for the first time with the Mayor's Committee on Persons with Disabilities. This year, we had more than 88 nominations for all of our awards, and a panel of judges from another municipality did the judging. And now to present our first awards, please welcome the Honorable Mayor Betsy Price.
Thank you, Michelle. Howdy. This is Cowtown, you know. And it's almost rodeo time. So what a better way to begin our day. There are a couple of people we missed acknowledging that I would like to acknowledge. Our base commander's XO, Commander Joe Seberg, is here from our base. Thank you for your service. Former council member Frank Moss is with us also. Frank, thank you. And several of our unsung heroes who really keep Fort Worth, the city that we love, and keep your neighborhoods safe. Our police, fire, and code officers. Would all of you stand so we give you a round of applause? Oh. These are the men and women who really do help make Fort Worth the special city that we are, along with your services. It's incredible. Fort Worth's now the 16th largest city in the nation and rapidly growing. And a statistic that continues to astound me, the Metroplex, Dallas-Fort Worth and our whole region, gains one new citizen every 4 minutes for the last 5 years. That's a staggering growth, and I think half those people are here in Fort Worth now as we manage that growth. So thank you for your hard work on your neighborhoods, for making this an extremely easy city for people to live in, for people to enjoy, to work, for businesses to want to come. Without you being involved, our neighborhoods would not be what they are. There's not a great city around that doesn't have strong neighborhoods. If you will look at some of the cities that are not succeeding where they should be, their mayors will tell you that one of the things they struggle with is lack of neighborhood and citizen engagement. And we have worked hard on our engagement piece, and you have made that job much easier for us. I'm going to take just a minute and invite our county judge, Glenn Whitley, up. He wanted to welcome you too and talk just a little bit about the county for you for a second. And then we'll move on to the awards, because I know that's what you're waiting on. Glenn?
And I have been told that if I speak very long, both of these ladies behind me are going to club me. The pastor could not have said it better. Because of your neighborhood associations, because of the way you care for your neighbors, that's what makes this city the great place that it is. And, you know, I'm very proud as Tarrant County Judge of this city and all of the other cities in the county, but I think your neighborhood associations really go a long way in your collaboration, and your caring for your neighbors is what makes this such a great city. I always refer to Fort Worth as the largest small city in the country, and it is that because you do care about your neighbors and you work together to make this a city that will continue to be somewhere where you want to raise your kids, raise your families, to entertain, and to work. And so I just can't say enough about how much I appreciate you. As the county, I would love to have an opportunity to come. If you have neighborhood association meetings and you need a speaker, give me a call. I'd love to come and talk with you to get your input and to hear from you as to what the county could do that would help you make your community, your association, a better place. I was a former CPA. My telephone number is 817-884-1040. You're all going to be very familiar with that over the next 4 months. So all you got to remember is 884-1040. Give me a call. I'd love to have an opportunity to come and speak. Thank y'all. Thank you very much. And congratulations to you winners.
Thanks, Glenn. Thank you, Glenn. And one more thing that is neighborhood associations you need to be aware of is January 21st through 29th is the Week of Compassion in Fort Worth, and that's Compassionate Fort Worth, and Pastor Woody is heading that up for us. We'll have lots of activities and lots of opportunities for you to get engaged, to do service projects, to do fun projects. Let's see if we can't get more people volunteering in our neighborhoods than we've ever had during that week. So with that said, we'll move on to what you've been waiting for, the awards. This first award is all about partnerships and collaborations, and it honors creative initiatives and neighborhoods that define a challenge and organize the community to make something happen. Most of all, it recognizes all of you who come together to work together, whether you're working with your neighborhood association, city staff, your council member, your county official, the ISD in your area, or whatever organizations. It's about finding the partnerships that will make positive changes in your neighborhood. So the HOA finalist in this area for engagement and community collaboration, if you would stand at your table when I read your name, we'd appreciate it. The first finalist is the Heritage HOA. Here they are. When they learned that a major apartment complex was scheduled for their neighborhood, not where they wanted it, They quickly notified their fellow neighbors, collaborated with the nearby HOAs and the North Fort Worth Alliance, dozens of residents, businesses, and neighborhoods, and successfully communicated their concerns about increasing traffic and other issues to our group so that we would be better educated on it. The second finalist is the Marine Creek HOA and their Bag of Hope project. Would you stand? Their Bags of Hope provided food, water, and toiletries for homeless folks. And the third one is the Tahoma Ridge Owners Association for military, would you stand? Thank you. For their military and first responders appreciation breakfast that they got donations and volunteers from their area business and served breakfast for our officers, firefighters, and our military family. And the winner is, we have a drum roll. There we go. The Marine Creek HOA. While she's making her way forward, I'll tell you a little bit more about their Bags of Hope. It began actually by accident when homeowner Cody Grant encountered a homeless individual a few blocks from his office. Cody began talking to the gentleman and then decided to do some research on the wonderful services that Fort Worth has to offer to homeless. He talked to his neighbors and they donated, Bags of Hope idea was born, and they donated toiletries, food, but most importantly, they printed up flyers and listed all of the services that were available for homeless folks and where they might be found, from clothing to medical care to job assistance. So congratulations to all of you at Marine Creek. You know, we used to say it's a Kodak moment, but I guess you now have to say it's a cell phone moment, because Kodak just doesn't exist. So for the Neighborhood Association category on engagement and community collaboration, once again, if you would stand when we name your association. First one is the Greenway Neighborhood Association. I saw some. There they are back here. I knew I saw some of them earlier. They collaborated with the church and the student projects on Martin Luther King and fixed elderly people's plumbing, fences, and minor home repairs for their neighbors. They also worked with Greenway Scholars in the summer lunch program to provide a productive and healthy summer for the kids. Our next one is the Historic Rosedale Park Neighborhood Association. There we are. They organized an expunction clinic after learning that many of their residents needed legal help clearing their records of minor offenses so they could remove the barriers that often kept them from good paying jobs. And the winner is, oh no, I'm sorry, there's one more. You know, you gotta realize I'm not used to doing paper. I'm an iPad kind of person. And they gave me a notebook and I went, uh-oh, how do I do this? Isn't that terrible? I'm very technical. So the other finalist is the Historic Southside Neighborhood Association. There they are. With the help of their churches, businesses, the school district, and the city, they re-energized and re-engaged their residents with an all-ages event at Glenwood Park, a front porch contest, national night out, and they even went Christmas caroling in their neighborhood. So congratulations. And the winner for engagement and community collaboration is the Historic Rosedale Park. Through their monthly meetings, surveys, and interviews, they learned there was an overwhelming need for legal services in their community. They partnered with the Historic Stop Six Initiative, Clifford Davis Legal Association, Tarrant County District Attorney under Sharon Wilson, and the Commissioner's Court, Fort Worth ISD, and hosted a legal clinic. About 100 people were able to get their court records cleaned up, and that included many who had been charged but never convicted of the crime. Now these residents are able to get better paying jobs because the inaccurate or expired information is now removed from their records. So thank you. All right, the other one is one we started, Michelle, 2 years ago. The Mayor's Health and Wellness Award, you can all imagine where that came from. And actually, yes, it's too cold to be outside, but I've been out this morning already. So today's, you should know about this one. It's about an organization, a neighborhood association, that promotes better health, exercise, safety, and recreation, because we all know that neighborhoods where people are out exercising, walking, talking, are safer neighborhoods because they notice things in their neighborhood. Healthy kids are better students and are more engaged. So there are two finalists in this category, and the first one is Crawford Farms HOA. Crawford Farms organized fitness clubs and outdoor activities that attracts residents of all ages. Thank you. The second one is the Harvest Ridge HOA. I know they're here. There they are, same table. They have free monthly fitness clubs hosted by a professional trainer, walking and running clubs geared to people of all fitness abilities and all ages. And the winner is Crawford Farms. While they're making their way up, I'll tell you a little bit about their event. They organize multiple events, including a camp out in the neighborhood for people to bring young children and their families. Their walkie-talkie club strolls the neighborhood 3 mornings a week, and the walking workers stroll the neighborhood in the evening after work. Their field days keep their school-age children active during spring break and summer break with basketball, kickball, and other games. And their regular water aerobics and Tai Chi classes are geared towards seniors. Congratulations. Let me know. I'll come work out with you. I've been up there for National Night Out. It's a fun area. And now for the Neighborhood Association Health and Wellness Award. The first one is the Como Advisory Neighborhood Advisory Council for its Learn to Swim Camp. There they are. They taught water safety and life-saving skills to both children and adults. The second one is the Ridgely North Neighborhood Association for their Friends of Bernie Park 5K Fun Run. Right here. They organized it to encourage fitness, communication, and to raise money for their park improvements and maintenance. The third one is the White Lake Hills Neighborhood Association for their neighborhood potluck dinner clubs and walking clubs that earned them the award for being the first official Blue Zone designation neighborhood association. And the winner is the Como Neighborhood Advisory Council. I have to tell you, this is a project near and dear to my heart because Fort Worth has the dubious distinction of having the most drownings among children under the age of 7 of any city in the state. And this group organized, there were 4 near drownings and 1 fatal drowning in the summer of 2015 in the Como neighborhood. They organized, along with Fort Worth Drowning Prevention Coalition, a Learn to Swim camp. But here's one of the cool things that they did. They got all the parents and the neighborhood leaders who couldn't swim to learn to swim first. And their message to the children was, if we can conquer our fears, you can too. And indeed they did. I had the opportunity to be at the Y when you got your final awards, and it was so fun to see the classes and the smiling faces on these kids, because I ran into several who said, I can swim now, I can go to the pool, and they were so excited. So congratulations to all of you. Michelle, I think it's back to you next.
Oh, get to my cheat sheet. The next award recognizes excellence in neighborhood communication, an important tool for bringing neighborhoods together. Newsletters are judged on content and appearance, as well as how well they reach their intended audience. Once again, please stand when you hear your name. Crawford Farms, Heritage, and Marine Creek Ranch HOAs. Also, if we could have the Eastern Hills Neighborhood Association, Oakhurst Neighborhood Association, Ridgely North Neighborhood Association, and Ryan Place Neighborhood Association, stand up. Congratulations to all of you, and will the newsletter editor or one officer please come forward to pick up your award and have a group photo taken with the mayor? So one person from each of those.
One from each group.
You all won. These were the neighborhood newsletters that were recognized as being the best. Some post electronic newsletters on their website, others use an email server, and some still deliver them directly to their members using mail or block captains, and they sell ads to offset the printing costs. A great newsletter, whether copied on paper or sent electronically, not only informs and invites, but it also helps boost the association membership. We have samples of all of these award-winning newsletters, so if you would like to see a copy so you can find a way to improve your newsletter, please contact the city's community engagement office. The Fort Worth Pride Award is given to an organization that improves the physical aspects of the neighborhood. Winners in this category may have completed beautification projects, community cleanups, park or garden projects, or worked with the city's code compliance and other departments to make their neighborhood cleaner and more attractive. Will the HOA finalists please stand? Harvest Ridge HOA. For multiple projects that helped clean up a neighborhood pond, plant trees, and add trash and recycling bins in a neighborhood park. The Villages of Woodland Springs, for improvements that added park benches, picnic tables, trash cans, and solar path lights in several green spaces throughout the neighborhood. And the winner is the Harvest Ridge Homeowners Association. Please come forward. While they're coming forward, I'll tell you a little bit more about their efforts. Harvest Ridge took on multiple projects this year, including recruiting volunteers for two neighborhood litter cleanups in the spring and fall. In Harvest Ridge Park, residents worked with the city to install 6 pairs of trash and recycling cans, restriped parking spaces,
and cleaned up and restocked a neighborhood pond after a fish kill. Residents also planted 78 trees to beautify the neighborhood and provide more shade. Congratulations to the Harvest Ridge HOA. Now will the finalists in the Neighborhood Association category please stand. Historic Rosedale Park. For a public art program that incorporated the history of the Stop Six area while making a neighborhood basketball court and playground more attractive. Overton South Neighborhood Association. For organizing volunteers to place 975 American flags in front of every home in the neighborhood on the 4th of July, a massive display honoring our active military and veterans. And the Ridgely North Association. For their continuing efforts to revitalize and beautify Burney Park, this year's projects included planting new shrubbery and flower beds and installing a water-saving drip irrigation system. And the winner is Historic Rosedale Park. Historic Rosedale Park partnered with the city's graffiti abatement program, TCU Community Scholars, a neighborhood print shop, and other clubs and organizations. Residents were involved in the design process, so the Story of Stop Six mural contains elements from the neighborhood's rich cultural and historic development. The bright colors and bold design painted entirely by students and volunteers bring attention to the Martin Luther King Community Center basketball court and playground. And the neighborhood has more teens and families using the facilities because of it. Congratulations to the Historic Rosedale Park. The Spirit of Fort Worth Award is given to associations that foster social revitalization, enhance cultural aspects of the neighborhood, or just simply make residents feel welcome and connected while working, playing, or celebrating together. Will the HOA finalists please stand? Heritage HOA. For its charity poker club tournament, in addition to the tournament, they secure donations of food and gifts for a raffle and silent auction. It was well attended, and it raised more than $10,000 for the Assist the Officer Foundation. Marine Creek Ranch, for helping a neighbor who was injured in a car accident, it started with individuals providing meals and mowing and grew into a major fundraiser to help pay medical bills. And Villages of Woodland Springs, for setting up a series of events throughout the year that appeal to young and old, including the Daddy-Daughter Dance, Easter Egg Hunt, 5K run, a school's out luau, and a 4th of July celebration, just to name a few. And the winner is Marine Creek Ranch. While they're coming forward, let me tell you a little bit about their community spirit. The injured neighbor was none other than Police Officer Kyle Davis. When residents found out that he would have a long recovery, they knew they had to do more than just provide meals and lawn care. They organized a Back the Blue barbecue sale and silent auction that raised money for the officer and his family. But the barbecue turned into more than just a fundraiser. It ended up being a celebration of Officer Davis's survival and recovery, and a testament to the neighborhood's strong sense of community. Congratulations. Now for the Neighborhood Association finalists. Please stand as I read your name. Fairmount Neighborhood Association. For its Festivus Light Tour that encouraged neighbors to decorate their homes for the holidays, then come together to enjoy each other's company on a shuttle bus tour of the lights. The Linwood Neighborhood Association.
for negotiating amenities the whole neighborhood can enjoy, including a new pavilion and entrance sign at Sandoval Park, new street topper signs, a Christmas giving event for neighborhood children. And finally, White Lakes Hills Neighborhood Association for their efforts to help longtime residents connect with newer, younger residents through a rejuvenated 4th of July parade and picnic that attracted 300 neighbors. And the winner is Fairmount Neighborhood Association. While they're coming up for pictures, I'll tell you a little bit more about what they did. The Fairmount Festivus Lights Tour was created to bring neighbors from diverse backgrounds together for a community-wide celebration. Residents were encouraged to decorate their homes to show off their unique holiday spirit. Elderly or disabled neighbors got help from volunteers who installed lights purchased by the association, making sure no one was left out. Planned stops along the shuttle bus tour allowed residents to get to know each other over hot chocolate, snacks, live music, and children's crafts. In all, 250 community members participated, many meeting their neighbors for the first time. Congratulations. Our next three awards will recognize outstanding individuals. I want to point out that these individuals have been nominated not by city officials or staff, but by you, members of the community they serve. The city's code compliance department is dedicated to maintaining Fort Worth as a clean, livable city. Code officers routinely patrol assigned neighborhoods for code violations, as well as investigate your complaints. Our Code Officer of the Year, again nominated by you, recognizes an officer who, in addition to investigating, documenting, and ensuring compliance with city regulations, also responds to the public courteously and efficiently, maintaining great customer service relationships at all time. Will the nominees please stand and remain standing as I call your name? Terry Bach. Okay. David Franco. Sherry Mata. And Mark Powell. Thank you for all of your excellent service to the Fort Worth neighborhoods. The 2016 Code Compliance Officer of the Year is Terry Bach. Terry was nominated by the residents of Eastern Hills neighborhood. They said she has fast response times to any code issues in the area and always returns phone calls promptly. Residents also like the way she helps educate new neighbors about the rules. In addition, Terry attends Wednesday morning Citizens on Patrol meetings and Eastern Hills Neighborhood Association meetings whenever possible. Above all, they cite her great attitude. Residents say she's an amazing resource, even for issues that aren't in her job description. Congratulations, Terry. Next, we have our Neighborhood Patrol Officer of the Year, and this recognizes a special classification of police officer. NPOs, as we often call them, do all the things a regular officer does, but they provide additional patrols and identify crime trends in specific neighborhoods or geographic areas. NPOs communicate with area residents and business owners, attend community meetings and events, and foster community leadership by recruiting volunteers for the Citizens on Patrol, Crime Watch, and other crime prevention tools. They are often your most important link to the police department. Again, these officers were nominated by you, the neighborhoods. Would the nominees please stand and remain standing as I read your name? Laura Charlesworth. Lloyd Cook. Ricardo De Los Santos.
Rodney Gilbert. Douglas Gilfer. Charles Gonzalez. John Ornelas. Bel Haddad. Sergio, I should know after it last year, but I still can't pronounce it. Guadarrama. Barry Sawyer. And Billy Ward. And the 2016 Neighborhood Police Officer of the Year is John Ornelas. While he makes his way over to get his award, I'd like to tell you a little bit more about him. Officer Ornelas was actually nominated by four different neighborhood associations: Fairhaven, South Edgewood, Village Creek, and the Villas of Eastwood Terrace. He is universally and affectionately known to neighbors as John John. He attends their monthly neighborhood association meetings and weekly Citizens on Patrol meetings. He also provides weekly crime reports. He recruits and trains neighborhood volunteers for Citizens on Patrol and answers questions promptly. But overwhelmingly, residents say that John John has earned their trust by being respectful at all times and taking a personal interest in the residents he serves. They praise him for his kindness to victims of abuse, the way he interacts with children, and spends time building and renewing relationships. I'd like to read from one of the nominations. We appreciate and love our NPO. We feel safe, we feel cared about, and most of all, we trust our NPO. Congratulations to Officer Ornelas. And now I'd like to ask Mayor Price to come up to announce our final two awards.
Thank you, Michelle. Congratulations to all of you. Let's give them another round of applause. You truly do make a huge difference in the city. You know, the Mayor's Committee on Persons with Disability is a group of citizens who work with us at City Hall, with the Human Relations Commission, to make Fort Worth a city that welcomes all. And I'm proud to say, with their help, we truly are. We have a reputation across the state and nation for being a very diverse and very welcoming city. The Danny Scarth Award is named for one of our former council members, Danny, who's right over here, and recognizes an individual who's raised the awareness of people with disability and helped improve opportunities for them. This year's awards, if you would stand, for our first finalist is Jacalia Dixon. Is she here? There she is, right there. Jacalia is 15 years old and inspired by her aunt, who was left blind after a surgery. She created a Braille clothing tag so that wearers can feel the color, allowing her aunt and others to more freedom to dress and match their own clothes. Our second finalist is Denise Kamey. Is Denise here? There's Denise. Who is a longtime advocate for people with disabilities, particularly children. She's a caseworker at Easter Seals of North Texas, and her passion for helping goes well beyond her professional work. She helps her clients understand their rights, locate resources, and navigate a system that often can be overwhelming to help them get what they need. Thank you, Denise. And the winner of the award is Jacalia Dixon. While she's making her way forward, I'll tell you that her first fill the color Braille tags were made by hand, and she sewed every one of them herself. Now she's applied for a patent and is seeking investors. One day she hopes that others who can't see the colors in the clothes they wear will be able to pick out and match their own things. At the same time, she's raising awareness of the daily challenges that people face with disabilities. Congratulations to Kayla. Kayla is a student at Eden High School in Hazlitt. Isn't that amazing for a high school student? Our final award today is the one that you've all been waiting for, the Neighborhood of the Year Award that recognizes excellence in all the areas that we've recognized today. For collaborating with us at City Hall, the county, other businesses, schools, other neighborhoods, looking out for resident safety, health, making physical improvements to their neighborhood, making it a more welcoming, social, and diverse community. The City of Fort Worth will send a representative from the Neighborhood of the Year to the NUSA National Competition a little later this year, and we've had great response at the national level. You know, the 2016 Neighborhood of the Year Award, when you think about these neighborhoods, you think about one word, and that's reach. The fact that they reach out to others, that they're not thinking just about themselves or their neighbor on their other side. When budgets are tight, they reach out to businesses in their community or to individuals, or get very creative and find sources that we have or potentially at the state and national level. What they often lack in professional expertise, they make up in creative and innovative ways and look for other professionals to help guide them. This year, all of the neighborhoods nominated truly reached for their goals. You've heard about one of their goals, and that was the expungement and foreclosure clinic. About 500 people lined up for legal help the first day that they did their clinic. People truly want better jobs and better homes for their family. You also heard today about their efforts to beautify and unify two recreation areas with public art projects that honor the culture and the long history of their neighborhood while involving their neighbors in the design process. And that wasn't all. They did the Stop Six Shape Up, a health and wellness initiative that encouraged residents to take control and be aware of their own health while informing neighbors of the issues in the community, organizing classes, and bringing in experts to help change the lifestyle for those in their neighborhood. They partnered with the historic Rosedale and Stop Six community to create a coalition known as the Historic Stop Six Initiative that has now become a model for other community collaboration. I'm proud to say today we're honoring the historic Rosedale Park neighborhood as our Neighborhood of the Year. Thank you all for being here today and for taking the time. Michelle, it's back to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mayor Price, elected officials, but mostly thank you all of you for coming out today and in participating in the workshops and our awards luncheon. I encourage all of you to, over the next year, look at the activities that you do, document them, and then definitely support, you know, submit packets for next year's awards. I would like to thank United Healthcare. They underwrote the event this year, which allowed us to provide everything free of charge to the neighborhoods, and so I would like to thank them for their support. And if that's not enough, they're also giving away a Kindle that they had people sign up for at their table. So Aaron Graves is going to come up and announce the winner of the Kindle.
Thank you, Michelle. You know, you should have received a ticket at our table when you first came in. I'll give you a second or two to pull out that ticket. And Madam Mayor, elected officials, and community leaders, I'd like to thank you for the opportunity to partner with you in this event. You know, just hearing all the amazing things and initiatives that you are implementing within your communities is so exciting. I mean, I don't live on this side of town, and I want to get over here as soon as I can. You know, Fort Worth is an awesome place, and continue all the good work that you do, and I'm just glad for the opportunity to partner with you, okay? So let me pull out the lucky number here. Absolutely. Okay. I need my reading glasses. 9-6-2-5-5-2-8. Do we have a winner? We got a winner. Awesome.
Thank you, Aaron, and again, thank you, United Healthcare, for helping us provide this to the neighborhoods. If you were a finalist this year, please come up. We have a certificate for you, and thank you for coming today and for making Fort Worth such a great place to live. We're happy to work with you.